Welcome back, friends. In the previous session, we discussed about the Mesomeric effect, and today we are going to continue with the categories or the types of Mesomeric effect. Kwa kama umeangalia kipindi kilichopita, ninaamini you have understood about the Mesomeric effect and you know everything about the Mesomeric effect. So today we are going to continue, and for the sake of today, we are going to discuss the types of Mesomeric effect and what are the effects of different types of Mesomeric effects. So Mesomeric effects by categorization, to categorize into positive and negative Mesomeric effect. So kuna positive Mesomeric effect na negative Mesomeric effect. If you remember to say a Mesomeric effect is the effect due to electron delocalization, electron pair delocalization. Ni effect ambayo inatokana na delocalization of electron pair. Kama tunayo compound, tunasema we have three conditions for appearance or existence of Mesomeric effect. Our first condition ilikuwa ni presence ya compound ambayo yenyewe itakuwa na alternate double bonds. Alternate double bonds. Our best example was benzene. And in the case of benzene, we say if this is our benzene molecule, if this is our molecule of benzene, then what we say is that these electrons, this bond is electron pair. These electrons, they can delocalize. They can delocalize. These electrons can delocalize to this position. These electrons to this position. And these electrons to this position. So at the end of the day, you are ending with structures of benzene. Kutuna first structure na second structure of benzene, which can be drawn as a hii bond itaenda pale itakuwa hivi, then itakuwa hivi na hapo itakuwa hivi. So this structure number one and this is structure number two. These two structures, they are called as resonant structures of benzene, resonant structures. So resonant structures, by undergoing delocalization or mesomeric effect, delocalization, at the end of the day, we are ending up with a single structure of benzene, which is called is the hybrid structure of benzene. The hybrid structure of benzene can be written as benzene molecule. Then we are drawing a dotted line in between here. And then after drawing this dotted line, we are indicating the movement of electrons, because here electrons also, they are moving. They are moving, they are not stationary. So we are indicating the movement of electrons. On our electrons in a So at the end of the day, our movement of electrons need anti-clockwise. Remember, this movement of electrons is not specific in direction. They can delocalize to any direction. Like what you need to know is that the electrons, they are delocalizing. Sometimes the hybrid structure of benzene, this is the hybrid structure. Hybrid structure of benzene. So sometimes the hybrid structure of benzene, instead here of drawing a dotted line, we are simply drawing a complete cycle, showing that the electrons in this benzene, they are moving. Now, kutoka hapa, mesomeric effect in a solution of movement of electron pair, movement of bond electron pair. That's why tulisema, katika conditions na mesomeric effect kutokea, lazima tuwe tuna a pi bond electrons, then lone pair electrons, or net negative charge electrons. Now, from there, today, we are going to discuss two categories, types of mesomeric effect. Kote na positive na negative. Tuanze na positive mesomeric effect. Positive mesomeric. Positive mesomeric effect. Positive mesomeric effect. Positive mesomeric effect ni kitu gani? Positive mesomeric effect ni ile effect ambayo inakuwa inatokea kama tunakuwa tuna movement of electrons au kama tunakuwa tuna delocalization of electron pair, lakini huwa kunakuwa kuna donation of electrons. So the localization of electron pair occurs as usual, but we have donation of electrons. So what we are saying ni kwamba positive mesomeric effect is the type of mesomeric effect which involves the mesomeric donation of electron pair, involve mesomeric donation of electron pair by substituent group which has reactive lone pair. So for example, if you have a attached group, an attached group in a compound, as for example hydroxyl, oxygen in a pair of two lone pair, how can you attach the group kama amine? Nitrogen in a one lone pair, now can you attach the group kama ester? Oxygen in a pair of two lone pairs. Sasa kwa sababu is substituent group, the substituent groups, substituent groups or attached group, because these attached groups, they contain atoms having lone pair. This lone pair can be donated to a compound having pi bonds, and then this can cause positive mesomeric effect. So the localization electron itatokea kama kawaida, lakini remember kwamba electrons zitakuwa zimetoka nje ile molecule, zimekuwa donated kwenye ile molecule. Kwa hiyo molecule husika lazima iwe na conditions for the localization of electrons to occur. Molecule husika, the specific molecule ambacho kuna ninayo, it must have conditions for the localization of electron to occur. Lakini these groups ambazo zimekuwa attached kwenye hiyo molecule zinapelekea sasa the localization itokee, lakini these groups nazo zina supply electrons. So we are saying that these groups, this attached group or substituent group, donate a lone pair to a positively charged atom in the species. They donate lone pair because of their presence of lone pair. Oxygen has two lone pair, nitrogen one lone pair, and another oxygen in ester has one lone pair. So they donate a lone pair to a positively charged atom in the species, and in doing so become positively charged. Thus, positively charged is delocalized and therefore is stabilized. Now, for example, we have an example in the compound like amino benzene. Yani tukiwa tuna compound kama huyo hapa. Huu ni mfano. Hapa kuna double bond, double bond, double bond. From here, let's say here tuna NH2. Then here we have lone pair. Now, how positive mesomeric effect inatokea kwenye compound kama hii hapa? Kivipi inatokea? Huyu compound atadonate lone pair kwenye hii carbon. Akidonate lone pair kwenye hii carbon, that means hii carbon, it can't tolerate. It must break this bond. By breaking this bond, that means it has supplied electrons cell nyingine. So hapo itabriki bond ili iweze ku accept the electron, lazima itabriki hiyo bond. So it will break this bond and it will supply electrons to this carbon. So what will happen ni kwamba the double bond hii lone pair kitengeneza double bond. Remember tulisema kwenye principles of showing reaction mechanism kwamba a bond is formed between an atom supplying electrons and an atom receiving the electrons. So nitrogen hapa imetoa electron, carbon hiyo hapa amefanya amesend electrons. So the bond must be formed between nitrogen and this carbon. So what will happen here ni kwamba tutakuwa tuna benzene ambayo tayari structure of benzene sasa hivi tutakuwa na benzene kama hiyo. Then hapa tutakuwa na double bond NH2. Pale tutakuwa na positive. Why we have this positivity? Because alikuwa na lone pair, amedonate lone pair, kwa hiyo atabakia positive.
That bond imetokana na nini? Na kwamba nitrogen is supply electron kwenye carbon. So a bond must be formed. Then from there, here we'll have a negative charge. We'll have a negative charge. Tukisha kwa negative charge yoko, hapa chini, our double bond itabakia, na hapa our double bond itabakia, vile vile. Now this is the hybrid structure, and this is the hybrid structure. From here, huyu charge atabilocalize kwenda kwenye carbon yule pale. Now, in order, hii carbon iweze ku accept E negative, because of this negative, that means it is the net negative charge electron pair. Kwa hiyo huyu negative sio tu negative, ni electron pair. Electron pair zoko kwenye hii bond hapa ilivunjika, electron pair zikaja ndio hii negative. So this negative is electron pair. Hii electron pair iweze ku accept by this carbon. Hii carbon lazima ibreak bond. So this carbon will break this bond, supplying electrons to this carbon. Now you see, tutapata hybrid structure nyingine hapa, ambayo hybrid structure itakuwa ni benzene. Tutakuwa tuna benzene hapa. Tukishakuwa tuna benzene, negative charge yetu itaangia pale, then hapa tutakuwa tuna double bond as usual, na hapa pia tutakuwa tuna double bond, then huku tutakuwa tuna double bond tena. Hapa tutakuwa tuna positive NH2. Hii itakuwa pia ni hybrid structure. Unaona? From here, these electrons pia zitakuwa nini? Mesomeric, zitaenda hapa. Zikishaenda hapa, huyu hapa atabreak bond na supply wapi? Pale. Na baada ya kubreak bond na supply pale, tutapata hybrid structure mwingine. Reason behind ni ile kwamba huyu anaweza accept electrons akazidi octet loop. Kwa hiyo ili aweze concept hizi electron pair lazima break the bond. Kwa hiyo tutapata hybrid structure nyingine. Ambayo hybrid structure nyingine itakuwa inaonekana kama ni benzene. Then tukishakuwa tuna benzene, tutakuwa tuna hapa itakuwa ni double bond. Then huyo hapo ame supply pale. So a bond will be formed here, hii bond itavunjika. So tutakuwa na double bond pale, this itakuwa ni negative. Negative charge, hapa itakuwa na NH2 positive. Unaona? Now, tumeshapata hii structure nyingine, there another hybrid structure of benzene. From here again, these electrons will be donated to this carbon. And by donating electrons to this carbon, again this carbon cannot accept electrons before breaking the bond. So the bond will be broken, releasing electrons back to nitrogen. So here hapa ita supply electron pale, bond itakuwa formed hapa, electron sisi hapa zitarudishwa pale. Kwa hiyo kitakachotokea hapo, tutakuwa tuna another hybrid structure ambayo tutaichora kama benzene, tutaichora kama structure of benzene. And then after having the structure of benzene, tutakuwa tuna double bond hapa, tutakuwa na double bond pale, tutakuwa na double bond pale. Hii imesharudi pale juu, so tutakuwa tuna NH2 ambayo ina lone pair pale. So this is what happens. The electron pair tend to be localized from here, then rotates the benzene ring, rotates the benzene ring, and then of the day they are coming back here. Kwa hiyo kama tungetaka tuseme kwamba this is how the localization how positive mesomeric effect in nitrobenzene tend to take place. Ini amino benzene tend to take place. Now, hii ndio amino benzene na hivi ndivyo ambavyo positive mesomeric effect inatokea. Kwa hiyo kutoka hapo sasa tunasema kwamba hybrid structures is totally resonant structure. The hybrid structure of this compound inaweza kachorwa kama hivi. Inaweza kachorwa kama hivi. Then after that unaweza kuweka double bond zako. No, usiweke double bond. Weka hapa NH2. Lakini from there, hii electron pair ina delocalize. So it starts from there, then it delocalize. For our case, ilikuwa ina delocalize in this direction. It delocalize in this direction. It delocalize. Then at the end of the day, now you see, electron pair hapa imeingia. Ilipoingia, imesababisha delocalization in ndani. Eh, imesababisha delocalization in ndani. So hii electron pair inakuwa inazunguka, inazunguka na tena kule inazunguka. That is how possible mesomeric effect inatokea. Kwa hiyo kiujumla ni kwamba positive mesomeric effect tunakuwa tuna donate electron kwenda kwenye compound fulani. Attached group ndio inakuwa na lone pair ambayo hiyo lone pair ina enable donation of electrons. Kama hapa ambapo tumeona tunakuwa tuna hiyo amino group yenye lone pair kwenye nitrogen. So hiyo lone pair ina donate electron kwenda kwenye hiyo compound ambayo ni benzene. Kwa hiyo tukisha donate electrons kwenda kwenye compound ambayo ni benzene, at the end of the day tunakuwa tunapata mesomerism kama hiyo tunakuwa tunapata mesomerism. So tunachokisema hizo zote zilikuwa ni just resonant structure, then the hybrid structure inakuwa ina muonekano kama ule pale after delocalization. So the amino group donates electron pair in benzene ring by possible mesomeric effect. And the general illustration of the positive mesomeric effect ndicho kitu ambacho kama kimeelezewa hapa. Now, one thing you need to note or you need to remember is that donation of electron pair by substituent group towards benzene ring by possible mesomeric effect increases reactivity of benzene towards coming electrophile. Now, tunafahamu kwamba benzene inaact kama nucleophile. Inaact kama nucleophile. And because it acts like a nucleophile, it tend to supply electron to an electrophile. Kwa hiyo sasa, group yote ambayo ina donate electron kwa benzene inaongeza reactivity yake kwa electrophile. Kwa hiyo kama benzene nucleophile na ina supply electrons, kwa hiyo tukiongezea electrons tunakuwa tumeongeza reactivity of benzene. In other words, tungesema kwamba in other words or in simple words ni kwamba tunapokuwa tuna group yote nayo cause positive mesomeric effect, any group which causes positive mesomeric effect, it leads to or it activates the benzene ring. Tunaziita activators zinafanya benzene iwe more reactive towards electrophile. So they are called as activators. So some of the few examples of activators ni hizi groups hapa. Pia we have many groups of activators, na tutakapokuwa discuss kuhusu benzene tutaona the series how or which group tend to activate benzene more as compared to another. So we are saying that for example in phenol, the hydroxyl group, tunaposema phenol tunakuwa tunamaanisha ni benzene. Tunaposema phenol tunamaanisha ni benzene yenye hydroxyl kama hivi. Au hii ni sawa sana kwa kuchora, ni sawa sana kuchora afu ikiwa na hydroxyl. Hii ndio tunaita ni phenol. This compound is what you call as phenol or benzyl alcohol. Sasa in phenol the hydroxyl group show positive mesomeric effect due to the delocalization of lone pair on oxygen atom towards benzene ring. Thus the electron density of benzene ring is increased particularly at ortho and para positions. Now what does it mean when you are talking ortho and para position? Nafahamu kwamba wengi wenu, na sio tu wengi wenu, nafahamu kwamba wengi amesoma bio chemistry. So this is the first time to hear about ortho and para. No problem, and don't worry. Tunapokuwa tuna an organic compound kama hii hapa, more especially ni benzene. Kwenye benzene tunaweza kwa tuna attach group here. So hapa tuna attach group, let's say this attach group as a group M. So don't worry, M is just an example. So from group M tutakuwa tuna first carbon. From group M tutakuwa tuna first carbon kutoka kwenye group M. Tutakuwa na second carbon na tutakuwa na third carbon. This is on the right hand side. And also on the left hand side, on the left we'll have first carbon, second carbon and third carbon. Now what do we mean when we are talking of ortho and para? In first carbon, tukitoka kwenye group M, first carbon upande wa kushoto na kulia tunaita ortho. Hii hapa inaitwa ortho. Tukitoka kwenye ortho, inayofuata second carbon hii na hii zinaitwa meta. Meta. So this is the meta and this is meta. Then hii hapa chini ni para. So the also and para position depends on the attachment of the group. For example, in your final compound here, to be done with your ortho in here, this will be our ortho. And this will be our meta. And this is our para. So like I said, why para will go chini, uku para uku shoto? No. Tunangalia carbon. Carbon ya kwanza, hapa imekuwa touched ya jote. Carbon ya kwanza ni ortho. Ya pili yake ni meta, ya tatu ni para. Huku hii maraki itakuwa ortho. Hii ya pedagogua ni meta. Para ni ile moja. Kwa hiyo, hii ndio inachokuwa inamaanisha kwenye ortho na para. So the activation of phenol. Tunapoongeza electron pair kwenye phenol by positive mesomeric effect kwa kutumia hydroxy group, inafanya phenol hiyo more reactive, more especially at ortho and para position. So ortho tunakwenda kuzungumzia position hizo hapo and para position. Hapa ndipo ambapo reactivity ya phenol inaongezeka. Na tunaenda kuona zaidi tutakapokuwa na discuss kuhusu phenols kwamba each kitu kina affect vipi different reactions of phenols. So tunachokisema ni kwamba hiyo inaongeza reactivity more especially at ortho and para position. And the reason behind this is because of the nature of mesomeric effect in this compound. The nature of mesomeric effect. Kama nakumbuka tumediscuss hapa mesomeric effect in aminobenzene. And in phenol, it is not so much different from aminobenzene. Remember, if this is the structure of phenol, now mesomeric effect, how will occur is that if this electron they are donated to this carbon, then this carbon should break this bond to this position. Now you see, this first position you say it is ortho, will break the bond to ortho position, and here we'll have a negative charge at ortho position. So if this will supply electrons here, then this carbon will break this bond to this position. You see? Kwa hiyo, wakati huyo amesupply electron yako, amesupply electron yako, bond itakuwa formed. Lakini, negative charge itahamia at para position. Because this is also, this is para position. If you remember, unaona hii, tulisema hydroxy ikiwa touch yako, this is our ortho position, and this is our para position. So if we consider mesomerism in phenol, if we are considering mesomerism in phenol, then you are saying this is our phenol compound. Tuichole tu kama tukichole pale mwanzoni. If this is our phenol compound, and then we have lone pair here. So donating this electron to this carbon, tutapata hii hapa, hii bond itavunjika, ita supply electron hapa pale. And remember, tulisema hii ni nani? Ni ortho position. Kwa hiyo manake, electrons zitakuwa donated to ortho position. Then what will be formed here in the hybrid structure will have benzene. And then after this benzene will have this bond, a negative charge at ortho position, then double bond OH here will have positive charge. So reactivity of benzene has been increased at ortho position. Why? It is because of the increase in electron density at ortho position. Thus, enable the donation of this electron towards an electrophile, which is coming. From there, we'll have another structure of phenol. And this structure, itakuwa hii hapa, ime supply electron to what? To ile carbon ya nani? Wa meta. Huyu carbon ya meta, ata break bond, bond ile pale, ata supply wapi? Para position. So from there, tutakuwa tuna phenol, kama hiyo hapo. Then tutakuwa tuna hiyo hapo, and then hii bond itakuwa imevunjika, tutakuwa na bond ya a new bond. Hapa tutakuwa na raw bond kama kwa ile oxygen, hydrogen, then positive charge, and then here we'll have a negative charge. Now you see, kwamba negative charge ilipotoka kwenye ortho, imehamia moja kwa moja wapi? Kwenye para position. Hakuna negative charge kwa nini? Kwenye meta position. So the reactivity of benzene, hii negative charge kitoka tena hapa, ikisupply hapa, maana yake bond atavunjika, ata supply wapi? Pale. Ambapo again this is an ortho position. So result in the structure ambayo itakuwa in exist as hapa tutakuwa na benzene ring, then after having benzene ring, hapa tutakuwa na negative charge, double bond oxygen H, hapa tutakuwa na positive charge, then hapa tutakuwa tuna bond here. You see? Again, this is an ortho position. So the reactivity of phenol, due to possible mesomeric effect, our activation, because here we activate phenol, and these are the resonant structures of phenol. Actually, what happens, ni kwamba the structure of phenol simply ni hapa. This is the simple structure of phenol. In the structure of phenol. Lakini hizo nyingine ni just resonant structure. Zile structure nyingine ni resonant structure. Kwa hiyo sasa, reactivity ya phenol inaongezeka humu ambapo mnakuwa na negative charge. Humu tunasema kwamba mnakuwa na electron pair ambayo inaweza ikawa easily donated towards an electrophile, because an electrophile ni species ambayo inakuwa ni electrons deficient. Kwa electron pair zinakuwa easily donated towards an electrophile ambayo zinakuwa hapo kwenye ortho position. Kwa hiyo hiyo ni just illustration kivipi reactivity of phenol increase at ortho and para position. Ortho pamoja na para positions ndiko ambapo reactivity of phenol tend to increase. So hence phenol is more reactive towards electrophile, towards electrophilic substitution reaction, to compare na benzene yenyewe. Phenol is more reactive as compared with benzene. The substitution is favored more at ortho and para positions. Why? Kwa sababu ya hiyo positive mesomeric effect inayotokea. So note, all substituents that donate electron pair to benzene ring to attach to it are called activators. Zinaitwa nani? Activator. Na nimeelezea kwamba zinaitwa activator kwa sababu zinaifanya benzene iwe more reactive. Kwamba benzene ilipokuwa peke yake ilikuwa ina react. Lakini unapokuwa unaongeza group inayo donate electron to benzene, that means unaongeza uwezo wa benzene kudonate electrons. Nilisema mifano kwamba kwenye positive mesomeric effect, manake benzene yeye anapo act kama nucleophile ana supply electrons. Hasa ku supply electrons ni kwa sababu yeye manake yuko electron rich. In other words, to say hivi, mtu anagawa vitu, lakini anapoongezewa kitu chengine, moyo wa yeye kugawa vitu unaongezeka. So uchoyo unapungua. Ndio kama benzene. Benzene anagawa electrons. Anapo act kama nucleophile anagawa electrons. So anapogawa electrons, that means having another group which donate electrons towards benzene increases the reactivity of benzene. So hence, this substituent make benzene ring to be more reactive due to addition of extra electrons to it. Hence, phenol and phenylamine are more reactive than benzene. Hiyo ndo phenol, na kama tunaita kama ni phenylamine ndio ile ambayo tuko tumeichora pale mwanzoni. Ama ina benzene, sometimes it's called as the phenylamine. NH to this the phenylamine or the amino benzene. They are more reactive as compared to benzene itself. Kwa hiyo, hivyo ndio mambo tunamaliza discussion yetu kuhusu possible mesomeric effect. Now, tunaendelea na negative mesomeric effect. Negative mesomeric effect inakuwaje? Sasa, negative mesomeric effect, as the terminology suggests, it will involve the withdrawal of electrons. From a certain molecule or a certain compound. And due to withdrawal of electrons, itafanya hii compound kama ni benzene iwe less reactive. Itafanya benzene iwe less reactive. So tunachosema ni kwamba negative mesomeric effect in the type of mesomeric effect which involve the mesomeric withdrawal of electron by a substituent group. Mesomeric withdrawal of electron by substituent group which contain multiple bonds and can also form negative ions by mesomerism. So hapa kuna kwa kuna substituent group ambaye lazima wa rafiki wakiita multiple bonds. Multiple bonds. In positive mesomeric effect tuliona, lazima species wetu awe ya lone pair. Lone pair itamwezesha yeye kuweza kudonate electrons towards a molecule and to make it more active. Lakini hapa in negative mesomeric effect, now we are talking of the negative one. In negative mesomeric effect, lazima species wetu awe ana multiple bonds. Species wetu awe ana multiple bonds. Kwa tunachokisema kuhusu negative mesomeric effect ni kwamba kuna baadhi ya groups ambazo they are normally causing negative mesomeric effect. For example, we have nitro group, we have a sulfuric group which is SO2OH. Here is sulfuric group. Then you have a carbon group ambayo ni kani XO, but normally here inakuwa ni carbon, simply saying carbon 24, carbon group. Then from there we have carboxylic group which is COOH, and then from there we have acyl group which is C-O-Choline. Hizi ndio groups ambazo normally zinakozi ni negative mesomeric effect. Negative mesomeric effect. Now ukizifuatilia hizi groups zote zina double bond, zote zina multiple bond. So multiple bond kwa mfano kwa hiyo hapa inakaa C double bond oxygen OH. Hiyo ni multiple bond kwa hiyo hapa. Lakini hizi groups zote zinakozi na multiple bonds. Now these groups will stabilize the negative charge carbon atom or carbon anions by delocalizing the negative charge from carbon group or carbon anion group. So tunapokuwa tuna hii group kwenye molecule fulani, let's say molecule ina negative charge, so assume you have a certain molecule, let's say it's carbon, then this carbon has a negative charge. But this carbon is bonded to maraki na bondi ina bondi mbili, hatuwezi kuchora bondi nne kwa sababu gani? Ikiwa na bondi nne maraki ile ya charge si iko. So ina bondi mbili, tatu hapa. Bondi ya nne ndio hii hapa negative charge. Hii ni electron pair. So hii ni bondi kwenye S double bond O, then from there double bond O, then OH. So this is the sulfuric group ambayo tumeandika hapa. This is the sulfuric group. And then hii group inaweza cause negative mesomeric effect. Kuweza to stabilize hii negative charge. So these electrons they can be donated to this position. And then by donation of these electrons to this position, oxygen having two lone pairs. All of these oxygen they have two lone pairs. Hii hapa inaweza ka break ka donate electron up for oxygen. So tutapata resonant structure mwingine ambayo itakuwa ni carbon then double bond, hapa ni single bond vilevile double bond. Hii negative charge imeshaondoka sasa, maana hapa itakuwa ni sulfur, pale ni single bond oxygen, two lone pairs, then hiyo itakuwa na negative, hapa itakuwa na hydroxyl as usual, hapa itakuwa na double bond oxygen. Now you see, so the negative mesomeric effect katika huyu group ambaye ni sulfuric group amesababisha negative charge kwenye carbon ya kufanya akaondoka. So tunasema huyu sulfuric group amestabilize the negative charge in this carbon. Amestabilize. I will make this carbon ion to become more stable. I will make this carbon ion to become more stable. So at the end of the day, tunachokisema hapa ni kwamba huyu atarelease hapa, akirelease hapa, huyu hapa atabriki, atabreka pale. So at the end of the day, huyu hapa atarudisha tena pale, na huyu akirudisha pale, maana yake bond itabreak tena, itarudisha pale kwa kwa carbon. Hizi ndio hybrid structures the here proposed in Mesomeric effect. So the moment of electron will be between this carbon and this oxygen. Electrons will be like rotating this direction. So if we want to draw the hybrid structure, tutasema hapa, there is delocalization which is taking place. Delocalization, or sometimes tunaweza tukaiandika kama three arrows, kwamba tunakuja kupata structure fulani huku, ambayo structure tunaipata huwa inakuwa ni structure tunaipata hapo inakuwa ni carbon, tutakuwa tuna carbon, then tutakuwa tuna single bond, tutakuwa na sulfur, single bond oxygen, two lone pairs, hydroxyl, double bond oxygen. Then the electron pair, they are undergoing mesomerism from here to this oxygen. The electron pair, they are undergoing mesomerism. So hapa tutakuwa tuna negative charge ambayo inaundergo mesomerism. Negative charge inaundergo mesomerism kwa direction hiyo. Kwa hiyo hivi ndivyo ambavyo tunaweza tukasema tukaaccount for the negative mesomeric effect in the sulfuric group as one among the examples which cause negative mesomeric effect. Lakini pia unaweza kuona kwenye carbon group how the mesomeric effect tend to take place. For example, we have H2C, then here we have double bond, we have C, and then CH, single bond, C, double bond, O. Then from there we have CH3. So any compound ambayo ina two functional groups, in a functional group of alkene and in a functional group of benzene, ni carbonyl compound, yani ketone. Kwa hiyo ina two functional groups. Now, hii compound inaweza kuundergo positive mesomeric effect. I mean inaweza huyu carbonyl group ambayo ni huyu hapa anaweza cause negative mesomeric effect. So at cause negative mesomeric effect hapo, huyo electron pair atavunjika, ata supply electrons to this carbon. So ata supply electrons to this carbon, or in other words, ata supply electrons to this position. So by supplying electrons to this position, manake hapo bond itakuwa formed kati ya huyu na huyu. So hapa huyu bond atavunjika supplying electrons to oxygen. So tutapata a structure ambayo itakuwa ni C2C, lakini hapa atakuwa nani? Ni positive charge. Why? It's because it is deprived of electrons, but the bond will be formed between this carbon and this carbon. So tutapata hapa single bond CH, double bond then C. Hapa bondi moja atakunjika, tutapata oxygen with the two lone pairs and then negative charge CH3. So hii ndio structure yetu ambayo tutaipata, and from this structure mesomerism itatokea tena. Huyu ata breach, ata supply pale, huyu atamisha tena wapi pale. So this is how a carbonyl group can cause negative mesomeric effect. Maanake imechukua electron toka hapa imepeleka huko. Na unaweza kuona kwamba, kwa mfano, tunapokuwa tunachukua electron in this pi bond, maanake tunafanya uwezo wa pi bond ku release electrons, au uwezo wa pi bond ku act kama nucleophile upungue. Kwa hiyo pi bond ndio uwezo wake wa ku act kama nucleophile, kwa in this case au kwa in this phenomenon itapungua uwezo wa pi bond ku act kama nucleophile, tofanye utapungua. So this is how mesomeric effect inatokea kwenye hizo compounds za compound za carbonyl compounds. Hivyo ndivyo ambavyo mesomeric effect inatokea. Kwa hiyo tunachokisema kuhusu mesomeric effect hapo, tumeelezea mesomeric effect kwenye huyo sulfuric group pamoja na kwenye hiyo carbonyl group. Negative mesomeric effect ina deactivate benzene ring. Kwenye benzene, for example, kwenye benzene, tukiwa tuna group ambayo na cause negative mesomeric effect. And the famous one is the nitro group. The famous group to cause negative mesomeric effect in benzene is the nitro group. Nitro group, the group of mine is famous and cause mesomeric effect in benzene. Oil and cause negative mesomeric effect. Now, the negative mesomeric effect in benzene, in absorbisha, huyo hapa, huyu benzene, awe less reactive, kwa sababu, atapunguza electrons. Now, tutaenda kudiscuss in deep, tutaenda kukuna discuss kwenye benzene, kuhusu activators and deactivators. But remember, kwenye positive mesomeric effect in E7, groups which supply electrons to benzene, they are called as activators. Kwa hiyo, in other words, groups which withdraw electrons from benzene, they are called as deactivators. They are called as deactivators. So why deactivators? The word D, it is because they decrease activation of benzene, or they remove. D is simply like removing. For example, even in the biology, tukisema ribose means it is the pentose sugar. Deoxyribose, D means absence of oxygen, or oxygen is removed. Deoxy, oxygen is removed. Deoxyribose. So the sugar the same ribose, but is deoxy. It is removed one oxygen. But this is not our case. So the word D simply means it is like removing or decreasing. So, deactivators zinapunguza activation of benzene. Au zinapunguza the reactivity of benzene towards an electrophile. As we know that the benzene, they undergo electrophilic substitution reaction. Kwa hiyo, reactivity of benzene towards an electrophile decrease upon negative mesomeric effect by a substituent group. Kwa tunachokisema ni kwamba, negative mesomeric effect deactivates the benzene ring towards electrophilic substitution reaction by withdrawing electrons. From the example of nitrobenzene, the nitro group withdraw electrons from benzene ring towards itself, thus making benzene less reactive. Now this marks the end of our discussion about the negative mesomeric effect. Marks the end of our discussion about the negative mesomeric effect. And now let's go to discuss about some of the few effects of mesomeric effect in the reactivity of groups of organic compounds. Come on, you are easing factors affecting the properties and the reactions of organic compounds. Go to discuss mesomeric effect. As I don't count it, mesomeric effect in affectivity, reactivity of different organic compounds. So, to assume the effect of mesomerism at the delocalization on pi bond electrons. Effect of mesomerism at the delocalization on pi bond electrons. Now, what we are discussing here ni kwamba, je, mesomerism in affectivity, the reactivity of pi bond electrons. If we have the pi bond electrons, and then we are considering the effect of mesomerism. What will happen? Or what will be the effect of mesomerism in these pi bond electrons? So we are saying that characteristically, pi bond are very weak and they are unstable. Kama unakumbuka, tulisema kwenye organic reactants. Kwamba tunapokuwa tunamzungumzia A nucleophile is a compound which is rich in electrons. And one of the properties of nucleophiles, some of them, they donated electrons by using pi bonds. Some of them, they donated electrons using the electron pair. So nucleophile, they are electron-rich compounds, come about to be discussed. Now, come about to discuss, mama, kada kwamba, the nucleophile compound to kisema CH2, double bond CH2. This compound is a nucleophile because it uses its pi bond to donate electrons. So in this case, we are saying that the pi bond, they are very weak and unstable. Why? If you remember, we say in organic reactors, comma, the pi bonds, they are formed by unhybridized p orbitals. Unhybridized pi bonds, they are formed by unhybridized sideway overlapping of unhybridized p orbitals. Kwa kama utakuwa hawelewi maana sideway overlapping of unhybridized p orbitals, either utafuata session za general chemistry au utafuata session za kwenye organic reactant tulielezea hivyo vitu vyote. So by saying so, they are very reactive. To keep later electrophile up, it will be very easier for this pi bond to be broken down and to supply electrons to an electrophile. If an electrophile will approach this compound, it will be very easier. Now, the property of this pi bond differs from one compound to another. If we consider the pi bonds in different categories or in different families of organic compound, then you will end up with the point that in some of the families of organic compound, this pi bond, it will be unstable and it will be very easier for it to break, supplying electrons to an electrophile, undergoing electrophilic addition reaction. But in some of the organic compound, it will be very difficult for it to break, supplying electrons to an electrophile. And then at the end of the day, the compound will undergo electrophilic substitution. So instead of undergoing addition reaction, it will undergo substitution reaction. Now, substitution reaction is always a type or category of reaction which is taking place in the alkane. Why? It is because alkane, they don't have the pi bond. So the only kind of reaction which they can undergo is the substitution reaction. And the normal category of reaction which is occurring in the alkane, it is the free radical substitution reaction. So, tunachokisema ni kwamba, because of their weakness and the instability and the reactiveness, compares are considered to be nucleophile. So these compounds having pi bond, they are considered to be nucleophile. However, the pi bonds can be weak and chemically very reactive. Very, very unreactive. If and only if they remain localized. The pi bonds can be weak and chemically very reactive. Under what condition? If only if the electrons pair, they are localized. If the electron pair, they are localized. Now, what do we mean by the term localized? Localized simply means the electron pair, they do not undergo movement. So, zimekaa same plane, zimetulia, has undergone mesomerism. Tunapokuwa tunazungumzia localized, maana yake ni fixed electron position, they are fixed. Tunapoanza kuzungumza kuhusu mesomerism, hadithi inabadilika. So the story of weakness and the chemical reactivity of the pi bond in mesomerism, the story changes. How the pi bond behave in mesomerism or in delocalization? Because here the electron pair, they are localized. If they are delocalized, that means has in a fixed position, they undergo mesomerism, the story changes. So to justify this, tutatumia, tunasema kwamba, kama pi bond electrons zitafanya mesomerism, au zitafanya delocalization, easy pi bond electrons zitakuwa unreactive. So the situation will change, or the story will change. They will become strong and unreactive towards an electrophile. Now, to justify this, we'll use the two groups of compounds. First, we'll use the comparison between alkene and benzene. And then you will compare the reactivity of carboxylic compounds, amide and acyl chloride. So we start by comparing between arkene and benzene. Arkene and benzene in different, in the same conditions. How are they undergoing different reactions? Alkenes and benzenes. Benzene. So alkenes and benzenes. Why you tunaanza ku compare kuhusu alkene na benzene? In the same condition, at room temperature, what reaction alkene undergo? What reaction benzene undergo? Na hiyo baadaye itatupeleka mwisho kwenye jibu letu la swali kuhusu reactivity of these pi-bond electrons. Now, both alkene and benzene, they are unsaturated hydrocarbons with carbon to carbon double bond. So both they possess this category of double bond. Alkene is now benzene zinayo bond. But why the pi bond in alkene are localized? In alkene they are localized. They are localized. Why in benzene they are delocalized? Delocalized. So this is the major difference between alkene and benzene. In alkene they are localized, in benzene they are delocalized. Why the pi bond in alkene are localized? Those in benzene they are delocalized. Quite secondly, what are the consequences or what are the effects of delocalization? Quite secondly, the localized pi bond in alkene are weak, unstable, and hence chemically very reactive. They are weak, unstable, and chemically reactive. Weak, unstable, and chemically reactive. These are the pi bonds in benzene. Quiet notification comma. At room conditions, the pi bond in alkene break rigidly and make them to participate in electrophilic addition reaction. The category of reaction is electrophilic addition reaction. Electrophilic addition. Electrophilic addition reaction. Kwa hiyo hii ndio reaction ambayo huwa inatokea kwenye nani? Kwenye hawa alkene, electrophilic addition reaction. So, example for electrophilic addition reaction, let's say we have this compound CH2, double CH2 plus hydrogen bromide. Eh? If we plus hydrogen bromide here, tutapata CH3, then CH2 bromide. This is an electrophilic addition reaction. So to me add hydrogen pamoja na bromine to me add kwenye hiyo. It is called electrophilic because an electrophile is added first before the nucleophile. An electrophile is added first before the nucleophile. So in reaction mechanism tutakuwa na CH2 down CH2. Kwa hiyo hapa tutakuwa na plus na hydrogen bromine. An electrophile is added first, so the bond is broken. In this case, supplying to hydrogen, this will break, supplying electrons there. So upper tapata the CH3, then upper tapata CH2 positive charge plus bromine negative electrophile. Kwa the second step, we have to supply electrons pale, then you have to pata the end product of reaction CH3. Cyclone CH2 bromine. Now, hii sio kesi yangu sana kwa sababu nishaelezea hizi mechanisms zote kwenye categories of organic reactions au kwenye types of organic reactions tulishaelezea hizi mechanisms zote. Sasa basi, ninachokisema ni kwamba hii ni electrophilic addition reaction kwa nini kwenye alkene. The pi bonds in benzene, unlike those in alkenes, are delocalized. They are delocalized. As a result of this, the pi bond in benzene are strong, stable, and chemically reactive. So the phenomena or the story in the team changes. They are strong, and they are stable. And hence chemically unreactive. So the story in benzene and the story in alkene, it is different. It means very different. Weak and stable chemically reactive. Here, strong, stable chemically unreactive. So even the categories of reactions, alkene na benzene at undergo ni tofauti. Like in the reason behind is because of the localization of electrons. In alkene they are localized, but in benzene they are delocalized. They are delocalized. Konacho kisema ni kwamba, tukishare zen mesomerism in benzene several times. So at room temperature or conditions, the pi bond in benzene cannot break and make benzene undergo electrophilic addition reaction. So electrophilic addition reaction, when your room conditions, haiwezi ikatokea, kama vile ambavyo ilitokea kwenye alkene. This is due to stability of pi bond caused by delocalization. So tunachokisema ni kwamba, for the pi bonds in benzene to break or to make it undergo electrophilic addition reaction, very high temperature and pressure are required. Very high temperature and pressure. Tunahitaji pressure ya 200 atm. Remember, 200 atm is very high pressure. It is 200 times the normal atmospheric pressure. Because the normal atmospheric pressure is the 1 atm. So if you put 200 atm, ni 200 times. And temperature of 300 centigrade, 300 degrees Celsius. Here upper it is about 6 times because of the normal environmental temperature is always 25% degrees Celsius. I mean 25 degrees Celsius. Normal. Here ni kwenye environment is yoto. Here ndo normal nini? Environmental temperature. Kwa kwenye pattern ya tatu is like 6 times. Here kwenye pattern, I mean it's not 6, it's 8 times. 8 times. Because, yeah, it's 8 times. I mean, it is 12 times. Because you put 100, it's a call 4 times. Then times 3, it is 12 times. So, nabidi you double temperature kwenda kwenye 12 times. Na pressure kwenda kwenye 200 times. Very harsh conditions. In order to undergo electrophilic addition reaction in benzene. But under normal conditions, benzene undergo electrophilic substitution, not addition. Electrophilic substitution reaction. So we are saying that alternatively, at room temperature, which is 25 degrees Celsius, and pressure, which is 1 atm, benzene undergo electrophilic substitution reaction. Instead, which is a side hydrogen atom is replaced by a coming electrophile. So in electrophilic substitution reaction, tunapokuwa tuna benzene molecule like this one, hapa mara tunapokuwa tuna hydrogen. So that means plus maybe chlorine gas in presence of Lewis acid, aluminium chloride 3 is a catalyst of reaction. We are getting the product of reaction is this way, plus hydrogen chloride. So the side hydrogen is replaced by chlorine. And we showed this example for, we showed this mechanism of reaction when we explained about the electrophilic substitution reaction in benzene. Tulionyesha hii hapa inakuwaje. Tunaposema electrophile are replaced before nucleophile, tulieleza hii mechanism inakuwaje. Kwa hiyo ni vyema tu kaenda kupitia kuhusu types of organic reactions, na utakapokuwa unasoma kuhusu hizi substitution reaction, utaiona hii reaction ya benzene pamoja na mechanism yake jinsi ambavyo inatokea. Kwa hiyo I hope you have already understood jinsi gani ambavyo delocalization in affecting reactivity of benzene. Reactivity of benzene pamoja na alkene ina affect reactivity of benzene na alkene. So the stability of pi bond in benzene and in alkene is different simply because of the localization. The localization, the reason pekee inatofautisha the nature of chemical reactions which is taking place in benzene, the nature of chemical reaction which are taking place in benzene and those which are taking place in alkene. Now taking an example, umepewa swali. In harsh conditions, benzene can undergo addition reaction under harsh conditions. Kuchora hapa tu ni example under harsh conditions. Hii ndo benzene under plus 3 chlorine chlorine molecules. Hii hapa kwenye harsh conditions kama tulisema kule mwanzoni, such as ultraviolet light, ina uwezo kwa undergo addition reaction ikatengeneza kitu kama hiki hapa, chlorine. But this reaction is only occurring in harsh conditions. Also kama hapa tusingeweka UV light, tungeweka labda 600 degrees Celsius pamoja na 200 ATM. Hizi tunazita nini? Reaction conditions. Tena kuna these are very important in conversion. Tunapo convert lazima tujue different reaction conditions ambazo reactions zinakuwa zinatokea. Kwa hiyo in harsh condition hii reaction inaweza kutokea. Lakini kwa mfano umepewa swali, umeambiwa hivi, benzene, alkene and alkyne are all saturated hydrocarbons. Why alkene and alkyne undergo electrophilic addition reaction? Benzene undergo electrophilic substitution reaction at room condition. Giving chemical reaction account for this observation. So accounting for the observation in our question, we must consider the effect of mesomerism of electrons in benzene. Kwa hiyo maelezo yako kwenye notes, majibu ya swali kwenye notes. I can't read everything because of time. I can't read everything. Now note that other compounds have pi bonds but do not react using their pi bonds at room conditions. This is due to the stability caused by delocalization. Again, we say we will consider two categories of compounds, and we have already considered about the alkene and the benzenes. Now, moving to compounds such as amide, that is R, C double bond O, NH2, and then other compounds such as acid chloride, ambao tunayandika kama ni R, C double bond O, chlorine, compounds like esters, ambao itakuwa ni R, C double bond O, then O, R, and carboxylic acids, carboxylic acid ambazo ni R, C double O, OH. Hizi zote ni examples of compounds which do not react by using their pi bond because of delocalization. Kwa mfano hapa, huyu nitrogen anaoni pair delocalization kutokea this way. Hapa huyu hapa anaoni pair delocalization kutokea this way. Huyu hapa anaoni pair delocalization kutokea this way. Huyu hapa oxygen anaoni pair kutokea this way. Kwa kutakuwa kuna delocalization of electron, and thus hizi compound hazita react kwa kutumia hii pi bond. Ndio maana wewe ukakuta carboxylic acid ameact kama nani? Kama nucleophile as supply electrons. Never. Carboxylic acid act kama acid. Na pia hii in account for the carboxylic acid to be the strongest acid among all organic compounds. It is because of the mesomeric effect. So the mesomeric effect in carboxylic acid inafanya oxygen hydrogen bond iwe weak. How? Ngoja tuone. tuone hiyo story kidogo. Tuone hiyo story kidogo. Tunasema kwamba all of these compounds, they have pi bonds between two non-identical atoms. Their principal reaction is supposed to be nucleophilic addition reaction. But at room condition, this compound does not undergo nucleophilic addition reaction as expected. They does not undergo, I mean it's not nucleophilic, it is electrophilic because it has a nucleophilic. Has undergo electrophilic addition reaction come as expected. Why? This is because of the stability of their pi electrons, pi bond electrons, caused by the localization. Instead, this compound, they undergo nucleophilic addition reaction. So they undergo, I mean electrophilic, they do not undergo electrophilic addition reaction, they undergo nucleophilic addition reaction. Kwa hiyo, has he undergo electrophilic, zina undergo nucleophilic. Kwa hiyo, hiyo reaction natokea kwenye different cations compounds, kama mtenda kuona madai. Lakini tuangalie effect ya mesomerism and localization kwenye negative charge electron pair. Negative charge electron pair. Delocalization ina effect kubwa kwenye negative charge electron pair. For example, tukiwa na compound kama R, C double O, then tukiwa na oxygen ina negative charge. Kama tulivyosema kwamba hii condition ina favor mesomeric effect. Why? Kwa sababu huyu akisupply electron hapa, is electron itakuwa blocked down, itapeleka pale. So then we'll be having a compound which is R, then C, single bond oxygen, lone pair, negative charge, double bond oxygen. Sasa basi, tunachosema hapa ni kwamba huyu pia anaweza kusupply pale, huyu akasupply tena pale. Na hizi hapa ndio resonant structures. But what we are talking here ni kwamba hii negative charge is stabilized by the delocalization or by the mesomeric effect, by the mesomeric effect. So the delocalization as an effect of electron density of the net negative charge electron pair. Delocalization removes electron in as you know, removes electrons density of negative charge electron pair and take them to a far distant within the region where mesomerism of electron pair takes place, and in most cases make the compound to be acidic in nature. So unaona hapa negative charge electron pair is delocalized to carbon and then electrons get up kwenye oxygen. Kwa hiyo always compounds ambazo zina uwezo kwa magoti hichi kitu, they are acidic in nature. Compound ambazo zina magoti kitu, they are acidic in nature. Kwa tunachokisema ni kwamba it is delocalization and mesomerism of electron pair that counts for higher acidic strength of carboxylic acid. Now consider hii tunaita kama carboxylic ion. Consider this carboxylic ion. Yani carboxylic acid ambayo hapa kwenye oxygen kuna negative charge. Consider this carboxylic ion. Now carboxylic ion ina undergo yu mesomeric effect. Kama hapa unaweza kuona carboxylic ion undergo yu mesomeric effect. Kwa hiyo from here electrons they are delocalized to there, then they are delocalized. Kwa hiyo, at the end of the day, tutapata the structure of carboxylic ion after delocalization. After delocalization, either ukichora R au ukichora ni kitu kile kile. After delocalization, tapata R, then C double bond O, then hapa tapata, I mean C single bond O, tapata oxygen. Na hapa kuna nini? Kuna delocalization of electrons. So electrons will be delocalized in this way, tutaweka negative charge. Kwa hiyo inaonyesha kuna delocalization electrons. na hapo tuna electrons pair. Kwa delocalization electrons inatokea mimi. Delocalization of negative charge electron pair in the carboxylic ion resulting into reducing electron density of net negative charge on the carboxylic oxygen. In the example which broke the carboxylic ion. Now, this is because part of electron density of electron charge is removed and is spread over the whole carboxylic group. Hence, electron density which remains on carboxylic oxygen as net negative charge is zero. So in this case, the localization, it decreases the electron density at this oxygen. Then the electron density in a shift kwenda kwenye oxygen yule pale. Kwa hiyo, electron density at this carbon, at this oxygen, decreases due to the localization of electrons. Now also, due to the localization of electrons and the mesomerism of electron pair in the carboxylic acid, that means huyu tumemchukulia kama ni carboxylic ion. But the same effect, because oxygen contains lone pair, so the same effect tend to take place in carboxylic acid themselves. Because oxygen possesses a lone pair, is a lone pair that can be donated to this carbon, and our effect hapa itakuwa ni kwamba hapa tutakuwa tuna R, then tutakuwa tuna C, hapa tutakuwa tuna single bond oxygen, and then tutakuwa tuna single bond oxygen. Huyu oxygen hapa atakuwa na negative charge, then from there tutakuwa tuna double bond oxygen hydrogen. Huyu hapa atakuwa na positive charge. Why? Kwa sababu amedonate your lone pair. Kwa amedonate your lone pair, mbakia na lone pair moja, atakuwa na positive charge. Kwa hiyo tunachozungumza hapa nini? Tunazungumza kwamba hii lone pair iliyokuwa donated hapa by mesomeric effect. Sawa, mesomeric effect inakuwa inaendelea kutokea. So huyu hapa atadonate tena kwa huyu hapa. Huyu hapa atadonate tena pale kurudisha. Lakini hizi hapa ni nini? Ni resonant structure. Now we don't talk of carboxylic ion. Now we are talking of carboxylic acids, carboxylic acids. And what will happen in this molecule? Hapo itakuwa ni hivyo hivyo. Kwa hiyo inaongeza tu hydrogen kumshona. Hii mesomerism of electrons. Maana electrons zinatoka kwa oxygen zinaenda. Zina decrease the strength of this bond. The strength of this bond tend to increase in the carboxylic acid. So this decrease the electron density, decrease electron density of oxygen hydrogen bond, thus making the oxygen hydrogen bond to become weak and easier to break in aqueous solution, releasing hydrogen proton to the solution, making the solution acidic. Kwa hiyo hivyo ndivyo ambavyo tunaelezea kuhusu nini? Mesomeric effect. Due to the localization of the mesomerism of electron pair in carboxylic acid, the oxygen hydrogen bond in carboxylic acid is weakened. Hence, hydrogen is loosely bonded to oxygen atom. Hydrogen is loosely bonded, imekuwa bonded kwa bond only weak to oxygen atom. So, manake, this bond will contain low electron pair density. Hydrogen atom will be loosely bonded and hence easier to release it in aqueous solution. So, in aqueous solution, such loosely bonded hydrogen atom is readily released in solution is hydrogen proton and it makes the aqua solution of opposite carbon to become acidic. Makes the solution to become acidic. Now the localization of electron pair in conjugate carboxylic ion explain why carboxylic compounds are acidic in nature. They are acidic in nature. The localization of carboxylic acid, they are acidic in nature. Now, one thing you need to note, this doesn't only happen in carboxylic acids. It doesn't only happen in carboxylic acid. We have also other groups of organic compounds such as phenols. Phenols, the same fact of mesomerism and the localization of electron pair explains why phenol is acidic in nature, while alcohols are basic despite the fact that both have the same functional group. Kwa hiyo, phenol, kama nikumbuka, tulichola pale mwanzoni, this is our phenol, and alcohol, huwa tunaandika kama ni R O H. So tunachukua hapo na CH3 CH2 CH2 OH. This is our example of alcohol. So here we have phenol and here we have alcohol. Sasa kwenye phenol na alcohol, phenol is acidic in nature. Acidic in nature. While alcohol is basic in nature. Despite both, they contain a hydroxyl group. Kwa hiyo unakuta kwamba phenol na alcohol zote zina hydroxyl group. Lakini phenol ni acidic, alcohol ni basic. Phenol ni acidic, alcohol ni basic. Sasa unapokuwa unakutana kitu kama hicho, basi unapewa unajua kwa nini iko hivyo. Now the reason behind is because of the localization. We have possible mesomeric effect in phenol. Kama ambavyo tulielezea pale mwanzoni, the possible mesomeric effect in phenol. If you remember, tulisema kwamba huyu anakuwa na release electron pair pale. Huyu ata release electron pair pale. So tutapata nini? Huyu hapa release pale itakuwa ni hivi hapa, tutakuwa na negative downward OH. Okay, anyway ni kwamba kilichopo hii hydroxyl group ina release electrons kwenda huku ndani ya benzene ring. Kwa hiyo this bond will become weak and this hydrogen it will be easier to be released in aqueous solution. That is the only thing you need to understand in this discussion. For in the phenol, mesomerism and localization is possible in the carboxylic carbon. Hiyo ni kwa sababu ya nature ya phenol hivyo. This is because the alpha carbon to which oxygen is attached is bonded to beta carbon by fiber. Alpha carbon ndio hapa. Hii ni alpha. Beta manake carbon. Alpha carbon ni ile ambayo functional group ni attached. Beta ni ile carbon inayofuata. Kwa mfano hii hapa, hii ni nini? Ni alpha carbon. Hii ni beta. Kwa kwenye phenol, alpha carbon ni hii hapa. Beta carbon, kwa sababu kwenye every corner of the benzene structure, we have a carbon atom. Tuna carbon atom. Kwa hiyo, from the hybrid structure above, it appears that part of the electron density of the net negative charge for the phenol oxide oxygen. Tukiwa kama hapa tuna phenoxide, let's say kama hapa tunakuwa tuna negative charge. And because of the mesomerism of this negative charge, that means this phenoxide ion will be stable in aqueous solution. Because this electron pair, which is a net negative charge electron pair, it's not localized, it is delocalized. So it tends to move to or into the benzene ring, and then that leads to decreasing electron density. So, from the hybrid structure above, it appears that part of the electron density of the net negative charge on phenoxide oxygen is removed and released to benzene ring. Such part of electron pair density flow into benzene ring. So electron density left on phenoxy and oxygen as net negative charge is low. But at the end of the day, he in a reserve combat bond catch oxygen and hydrogen it aqua weak, thus easier to release hydrogen proton in aqueous solution, easier to release hydrogen proton in aqueous solution. So in the case of alcohol, mesomerism and deocalization are not possible in the conjugate base of alkoxide ion. So number 7 alkoxide ion manake ni R CH2O. Undo namuta alkoxide ion. Alkoxide ion aweza kanakuwa mesomerism kwa sababu gani? This carbon is not bonded to the next carbon by pi bond. There is no pi bond here. So it can't undergo mesomerism. So why? It is because the alpha carbon is not bonded to the beta carbon. This is the alpha carbon. Now alpha carbon nakona carbon nyingine. Let's say R then CH2 again. This is the alpha and this is the beta carbon. The alpha carbon and the beta carbon, they are not bonded by pi bond, they are bonded by sigma bond. And the sigma bond is strong as compared to the pi bond. This is because alpha carbon is not bonded to beta carbon by pi bond, but only sigma bond. Sigma bonds are not involved in mesomerism and in the localization process. Hence, the net negative charge on the alkoxide oxygen remaining high. Net negative charge hapa inabakia high vile vile. Kwa hydrogen atom inaweza pia kuattach hapa easier kwenye aqueous solution. So tunasema kwamba hydrogen atom that may attach on alkoxide oxygen becomes strongly bonded to it. The oxygen hydrogen bond in alcohol is stronger than in phenol. So hizi zote zina oxygen hydrogen bond, lakini the oxygen hydrogen bond in phenol it is weak as compared to the oxygen hydrogen bond in the alcohol. So in the aqueous solution, the oxygen hydrogen bond cannot dissociate easier. Alternatively, alcohols react by using lone pair present on oxygen. Oxygen react by using lone pair present on oxygen. While in phenol, they react by using this hydrogen. So they react by using lone pair present in the oxygen atom instead of dissociating into ions. Now note that the acidic nature of phenol is used as an important property for distinguishing phenol from alcohol. So when we start about the phenols and the alcohol in organic 2, tutaona different reaction ambazo zina distinguish phenol na alcohol. Phenol na alcohol. Kuna different reactions ambazo, yeah, they are very interesting. Different reactions that are distinguish different groups of organic compounds. Very interesting. Now, for example, kuna soil. How can you distinguish phenol from alcohol? How can you distinguish phenol from alcohol? Kuna majibu hapa. The first reason ni kwamba phenol dissociating alkaline solution to form salt. So itotengeneza sodium phenoxide salt. Wakati alcohol haifanyi chokitu. Sodium phenoxide salt, wakati alcohol haifanyi chokitu. Lakini phenol dissolve in the solution of sodium carbonate to form phenoxide salt and carbon dioxide gas. Sasa carbon dioxide gas, as we know kwamba, ukidissolve kwenye lime water, ina form milk. So that is also the chemical distinction between phenol and alcohol. Furthermore, details on the distinction between phenol and alcohol will be discussed under the part of organic 2, discussing about the phenols and the alcohol. When you organic 2, we will discuss whose alcohol. So from the above discussion that phenol and alcohol they are different, from the above it appears that for a compound to be acidic in nature, two conditions they are required. Ni condition kama zile za mesomerism, kwamba it must possess hydroxyl group. Compound iwe acidic kwenye organic compound, lazima iwe na hydroxyl group. Hydroxyl group ni very important kwa sababu bond now become weak in a lazy hydrogen. Kupossess hydroxyl group, then iko kuna uwezekano wa lone pairs kwenye oxygen kuundergo mesomeric effect. So the second thing is that the alpha carbon must be bonded to the beta carbon by pi bond. Alpha carbon to which a hydroxyl group is attached must be bonded to adjacent carbon atom, that is the beta carbon by pi. Hiyo ndio two reason ili kuweza kufanya compound yetu become acidic. So now we have discussed about the mesomeric effect. We have discussed about the mesomeric effect. Na tumeona jinsi ambavyo mesomeric effect inatokea hapo kwenye hizi compound. Tumeona ni kwa jinsi gani. Sasa tukamalizie some few factors affecting the organic reactions, the properties of organic compounds and organic reactions. Now tuangalie kuhusu reactivity of lone pair. Reactivity of lone pair. Now as we know about lone pair, lone pair is the pair of electrons which are not involved in the normal covalent bond formation. Or you can say lone pair is the pair of non-bonding electrons which is present in the valence shell. So it's the pair of valence shell electrons which are not involved in the normal covalent bond formation. Nimeelezea lone pair kwenye vipindi vingi vilivyopita, na hasa tulikuwa na discuss kuhusu the unique properties of carbon. Tulielezea kuhusu concepts of lone pair na all the things, discussions about how lone pair affect the reactivity of different compounds. Now a lone pair, they can be denoted by either mesomeric or by acting as nucleophile. Lone pairs zinaweza kufanya mesomeric effect au zinaweza act kama nucleophile kuweza ku release electrons. So nachokisema, they can form a dative covalent bond. Dative covalent bond, ambao kwenye dative covalent bond we must have a lone pair, one atom must have a lone pair and another atom. Tunaposema dative covalent bond, maana yake one atom, let's say oxygen, it has a lone pair, and another atom provides an empty orbital. Kwa sababu kwenye every bond unayojua wewe, tunapochoma hivi bond, maana yake tunakuwa tuna empty orbital. Ndani inakuwa ina two electrons. Hii na hii ni kitu kimoja. Yaani tunapochoma hivi ni sawa sawa na hivi. Sasa basi kwenye dative covalent bond, one atom must have lone pair and another atom should be provide an empty orbital. Hii inatakiwa iwe empty, haina kitu. Hii inachukua lone pair yote inaenda kutumbukiza pale. Ikitumbukiza, lone pair inakaa kama hivi. Tunakuwa tayari tuna bond. So this kind or category of bond is called the dative covalent bond. So the dative covalent bond is the type of bond in which all bond electron pair, they are supplied by single atom. Supplied by single atom. All bond electron pair, they are supplied by single atom. Kwa nacho kisema, ni kwamba, however, their atoms will soon try to restore its full electron count by either regaining the lone pair or by breaking another bond. So tunapokuwa tuna any atom imefanya reaction kwa kutumia lone pair, ile atom haiwi stable. Normally kwenye principles of showing mechanisms of organic reaction tunasema hivi, an atom ambayo ita donate lone pair ita become possibly charged. Why? It is because kuwa na lone pair kilikuwa ni kama hali yake ya kawaida. Kwa hiyo kumpa atom mwingine lone pair ni kama tu imemsaidia. Tufanye kwa mfano, mtu ameshazoea, ameshazoea kula chakula kiasi fulani, let's say for students in schools, let's say ameshazoea sometimes in school the code is double. Tunasema kama ameshazoea double, mwingine anasema ameshazoea double, mwingine ameshazoea kupiga touch, mwingine na lugha za shuleni za kufanya kupiga touch. Lakini kudabu kupiga touch ni kitu kile kile. Kwa kupiga touch ni kwamba mwanafunzi ameshakula sahani ya kwanza, ameshazoea kula plate ya pili. Sasa in case siku moja yule mwanafunzi ile sahani aliyodabu aliyopiga touch amemsaidia mwenzake, because ile sahani aliyopiga touch ni kama excess. Now ndivyo ambavyo inatokea kwenye atoms, kwenye these atoms, kwamba lone pair is just like an excess. It is not involved in a normal covalent bond formation. So lone pair is just like an excess. is just like an extra. Kwa tunachokisema ni kwamba kuhusu hilo ni pale tunachokisema ni kwamba hilo ni pale kwa ni kama excess, ni kama ile sahani ambayo mwanafunzi amepiga touch amemgawia mwenzake. Sasa because alikuwa anaitumia kula, maana yake siku ya pili lazima atasafa the problem kwamba sijala au sijaishi kwenye mazingira yangu ya kawaida ambayo nilikuwa na sahani nyingine ya chakula. Unaona? So due to that factor manake yule mtu aliyempa ile plate mwenzake atajaribu suni kutafuta mekanizmi ya yeye kupata chakula chengine. So an atom donating lonely pair forming that bond or performing mesomerism will soon try to restore in this condition. Na ndio maana kwa different conditions, kwa mfano tumetoa mifano mbalimbali. Tutolee tu mfano mmoja ambao tuliutumia kwenye sulfuric iron. Tukasema kwamba hapa tukiwa na negative charge, huyu negative charge inaweza kuwa supply ya huyu, labda aroni pair. Ajio supply ya ambayo ata break bond ya lenda pata. Lakini, ewe angalia hichi kitu. Unaona, huyu ana negative charge. Huyu kama ana negative charge. Huyu ni mfano tu. Akiwa ana negative charge ana supply pale. Anapeleka pale. Lakini, hapa tutakuja ku result to the structure ambayo itakuwa hii. Kama ile pale, negative charge inaondoka. Pale napata ni sulfur, pale single bond O, two lone pairs, kuna negative pale. Then double bond O, two lone pairs, then O, H, two lone pairs. Now, phenomena mnayoelezea hapa ni kwamba, unaona kwa mfano hapa, huyu ame supply bond hapa, tumetengeneza nini? A dirty bond. Now this is not lone pair, sio lone pair, lakini this phenomena also occurs hata kwenye mazingira ambayo ni ya kawaida. In normal environment, hii phenomena ya kwenye lone pair. Kilichopo ni kwamba hii carbon haiwezi kukaa muda mrefu bila ile negative charge yake. So it will try to restore its negative charge. Now how will it restore negative charge? If the negative charge was lost by mesomerism, that's the movement of electron. Also, the negative charge will be brought back by mesomerism. So hapa tutakuwa na mesomerism, ita bridge the supply pale, ita bridge the supply pale. At the end of the day, we will end up with huyu carbon tena atakuwa na negative charge vile vile. Kwa hiyo phenomena ambayo tunaelezea kwamba hata kwenye lone pairs, huyu carbon kama na lone pair atajaribu ku restore. Carbon is just an example. Carbon inaweza kuwa na lone pair. Yaani huo ni mfano. Carbon inaweza kuwa na lone pair. However, in some of the compounds such as carbon monoxide, carbon inakuwa ina lone pair, lakini normally carbon huwa haiwi ina lone pair. Kwa tunachokisema ni kwamba kampuni yetu itajaribu ku restore the normal condition. So oxygen and nitrogen are the main elements which have reactive lone pair in organic compounds, because usually their lone pair are in the orbitals of a type of hybridization which permit their donation. Oxygen and nitrogen ndizo atom ambazo tunazungumzia sana hapo zenye lone pair. So the lone pair become more reactive when extra electrons are donated to an atom possessing those lone pairs. For example, in amine. And in amine, tulisema, hili ni kutokana na positive inductive effect. Kwenye amine, tulisema positive inductive effect. Ina increase the basic strength of amine. RNH2. Here we have lone pair. We said the positive inductive effect increase the basic positive inductive effect. Positive inductive effect, increase the basic strength of amine. Kwa hiyo unachotaka kuona ni nini? Reactivity of lone pair, where alkyl group donates electrons to nitro atom and makes lone pair to become reactive and easier to be donated. Reactive and easier to be donated. Now note, the type of hybridization can greatly influence the nucleophilic nature of lone pair. Type of hybridization greatly influence the nucleophilic nature of lone pair. Now, how? Kivipi, the lone pairs in sp3 hybridized orbital, sp3 hybridized orbitals is a relatively large distance from the nucleus, so it experiences relatively weak force of attraction from nucleus than a lone pair in sp2 hybridized orbital. So, kama nakumbuka kwenye hybridization to discuss sana kwenye hybridization to discuss sana hii hapa kwenye introduction kabisa na unique properties of carbon. Tunazuka tuna s orbital like this one, and s orbital inaweza kuwa in a electron spiral, na ile pia tunazuka tuna p orbital ambayo p orbital let's say inaweza kuwa in electrons idadi yote, let's say the year 2. And in hybridization, we can mix these orbitals depending on the number of atoms required in forming the bond in hybridization. For example, this is what we call the ground state. Grounding state. So in the excited state, tutakuwa tuna here hapa with a single electron. This is maybe 2s, this is 2p, for example. So 2s hapa, 2p tutapata electron moja ambayo imetoka huko, tutapata huyo hapa na huyo hapa, tutapata 2p. From there this is called excited state. Excited state. So from the excited state tunaelekea kwenda kwenye hybridized. Tunaweza tukachagua either to mix s moja na p wawili, yani na p moja wawili au watatu wote. Lakini tukimix watatu wote tutapata sp3. Hatuiti sp cube, hatuna sp cube, ni sp3. Hatuiti sp cubic, it is sp3. So the sp3 hybridized orbital will be having electrons which are far from nucleus, and because the electrons they are far from nucleus, they tend to have weak nuclear attraction, and due to weak nuclear attraction, manake itakosa na uwezo mkubwa wa kuweza kuwa released easier. SP2 manake itashuka na SP1 itakuwa iko very close to the nucleus. So a lone pair SP2 orbital is much closer to the nucleus and therefore much more tightly held to the nucleus. As a result, it is very difficult to donate this lone pair to another atom, either by mesomerism or by nucleophilic attack. So by either mesomerism or by nucleophilic attack, inakuwa very difficult. Third, the lone pair sp2 orbitals are unreactive lone pair, and a lone pair in sp hybrid orbital is very close to the nucleus than in sp2 hybrid orbitals, and therefore much more tightly held to the nucleus by nuclear attraction. So in other words, discussion yetu hapa ni kwamba reactivity of lone pair depends on the type of hybridization. Type of hybridization. Kama hybridization yetu itakuwa ni sp3, manake huyu lone pair atakuwa far from nucleus, and then at the end of the day tutafanya compound zetu ziwe very reactive. Now we have another factor ambayo Gaiza ameandika kwenye kitabu chake cha organic chemistry. To the great percent, natumia na sangu, lakini it is better ukawa na Gaiza kama pia a reference book kuweza kupitia baadhi ya vitu ambavyo nimeelezea ambavyo kwenye notes zangu havipo. Kwa hiyo utapitia Gaiza kwenye page namba 45. Kuna kitu amekielezea kuhusu steric effect, or sometimes it is called the steric hindrance. Steric effect, the steric effect, or the steric hindrance. Now, what is the steric effect, or what is the steric hindrance? What is the steric hindrance in organic compounds? Now, when we are talking of the steric effect, heat effect inayotokana na attached groups. Tunakuwa tuna attached group, na attached group ina affect the activity ya organic compound mzima. Tunachokisema ni kwamba whenever a chemical reaction between two compounds takes place, direct or indirect, it results in the formation of bond between the two atoms of these two compounds. Now, the bonding atoms of two reacting compounds are in fact active centers. Bonding atoms, they are active centers. These will react, thus will form the bond, while one another only if they come within contact each other. Yani haiwezekani atom mbili zikatengeneza bond kama hazijawa in contact. Hazijawa in contact. So they become close to each other and then they form a bond. So in steric effect, kama tunakuwa tuna large attached group kwenye certain compound, ile large attached group inazuia atom mwingine kuja na kuattach. So let's say assume ni kama tu vile kwamba Rais Magufuli ameenda sehemu afu watu wamemzunguka. So inakuwa ni very difficult kwa mtu mwingine kwenda na kumuona huyo kama tu yule mtu yuko mbali. Why? Kwa sababu gani? Kuna many people wamemzunguka. Lakini pia mifano mingine hapa tukitolea sio mbaya. Wakati Yesu ameenda kuhubiri maeneo mbalimbali, maeneo mengi yalikuwa na kutoa wagonjwa, lakini kulikuwa kuna watu wengi wamemzunguka. Kwa hiyo kulikuwa kuna steric effect au kuna steric hindrance. Ilikuwa ni very difficult mgonjwa kumkuta au kuonana na Yesu au kuongea naye. Why? It is because of the steric effect or the steric hindrance. So sometimes people, they were forced kwamba watoboe paa la juu, watoboe wamshushe mtu kwa kitanda. But the reason behind is because of the steric effect. Now in organic compound, it is impossible kutoboa paa la juu, kushusha attached group iweze kuja kufanya reaction. So the steric effect, due to accumulation of large attached groups, it is very difficult to attach coming reacting groups to those organic compounds. So we are saying that if we surround one of them with such mass of other atoms, unaona? Manake pale ambapo reaction atakiwa itokee, panakuwa surrounded by large attached groups or large atoms or groups that other reacting atoms is unstable to force its way in. Kwa hiyo ile group inayokuja inakuwa ni very difficult kuingia na kwenda kufanya reaction pale. Kwa nini? Kwa sababu ile carbon imekuwa surrounded by large attached groups. Tenda kuona examples. So the reaction may not at all take place or may take place only slowly. Such a hindrance due to spatial clouding or clouding space, yani ile mkusanyiko, is called steric hindrance. Is called steric hindrance. So steric hindrance occurs when the large size of groups within a molecule prevents chemical reactions that are observed in reacting molecules with smaller groups. However, the spatial clouding may not always hinder reaction. Sometimes it may facilitate a reaction. It is often exploited to change reactivity pattern of molecule by stopping unwanted side reaction. That is steric protection. Kwa hiyo steric hindrance inatokea kwenye different groups of organic compounds. So steric effect ina modify the nature of organic reaction. Normally huwa inahinda, inazuia group ya organic compounds kwenda kuattach normally. Lakini hiyo sio kwamba ndio lazima kila muda hiyo hivyo. So hiyo ni normal. Lakini sometimes, so steric effect may be defined as modification in molecular properties resulting from spatial clouding or reacting molecules in a molecule. A good example of steric effect is discussed below. Asa, a good example, tuna tertiary amine. Tertiary amine ambayo inakuwa ni nitrogen CH3 CH3. Halafu huyu hapa anajiati na CH3 I. So huyu ni tertiary amine. Unamwona? Ni tertiary amine. Ana kama tatu simboli kwa nitrogen. Lakini huyu tertiary amine ukimjiatisha na huyu hapo. Methyl, yani iodomethyl. Iodomethane. Ukimreactisha na iodomethane, unakuja kupata compound nzuri tu hapa CH3. Then any CH3. Then hapa CH3. I. Hiyo, hii hapa inaita a quaternary ammonium salt. Quaternary ammonium salt. Quaternary ammonium salt. Lakini sasa hii hapa unavyoona ni tertiary amine. Sasa tukiwa tuna tertiary amine ambayo kuna R nitrogen, hapo tuna R tumeletisha na CH3 I, ambayo huku kama hizi R ni kubwa, let's say our R hiyo ni nini, hiyo labda ni CH2 CH3 labda tufanya R hiyo ni C. Hatu mfano hapa ugrupu kubwa inayoleta hindrance hapa ni C CH3. Kwa mfano, hii ndio iwe R yetu. So compound yetu tungeandika hivi. Compound yetu ili uone itapia vipi. Compound yetu tungeandika hivi. N huku chini tumekuwa na C CH3. Hapa tumekuwa na C CH3. Na hapa juu tumekuwa na C CH3. Unaona? Hapo hapa ndo tukamletisha nani? Huyu iodo methane. Sasa angalia hizi groups. Huyu group unamwona? Alafu grupu mwingine ni huyo. Alafu grupu mwingine ni huyo. Haya magrupu yanapelekea kitu kinaitwa clouding. Yaani haya magrupu yanamzuia huyu kuja kureact na nitrogen. So this is what we are saying in the steric hindrance. So in this reaction, no quaternary ammonium salt is formed. No quaternary ammonium. No quaternary ammonium salt is formed. No quaternary ammonium salt is formed. Kwa hiyo huu ni mfano tu wa steric hindrance. Kwa steric effect, kwa steric hindrance in affect the reactivity of amines. Kwa mfano hapa tuna steric effect and a decrease of basic strength in tertiary amine. Hizi ni tertiary amine. Sasa unaona hapa hii hapa imeongeza basic strength, unaona? Lakini hapa tertiary amine ikiwa na group kubwa ina decrease basic strength. Amine not only donates its lone pair to Lewis acid, but also welcome the Lewis acid to bond with nitrogen. So inductive effect of the alkyl group, they increase the reactivity of lone pair of this nitrogen. So tunachosema kwamba inductive effect study here deals with the ability of the amine to donate its lone pair. So this alkyl group, if they are small in size, they cause the positive inductive effect, thus increasing the ability of this nitrogen to release the lone pair towards the electrophile. But if the size of this alkali group tend to increase, like in this case, if the size of this alkali group tend to increase, that means the ability of this another group which is reacting to come and approach nitrogen will be difficult, and that will cause strength hindrance. So, however, amine with greater electron density may become weaker base if it is nitrogen is overcrowded with groups of carbons, thus making difficulty for it to bond with Lewis acid. This is the steric effect or the steric hindrance. The great or the bigger groups of carbons, bigger alkali groups, they cause overcrowding of nitrogen. Thus, it is very difficult for the Lewis acid to come and bond with the nitrogen. So, steric effect, specifically steric hindrance, is one which determine the ability of amine to allow Lewis acid to bond with the nitrogen. So in this case, the low-pair nitrogen might have or will have the higher ability to be directed because of the bigger alkali groups will make the low-pair of nitrogen needed to be released. But again, another effect which is steric effect, the reactivity of low-pair has been increased in this case, but the steric hindrance tend to inhibit the approach or tend to hinder the approach between these two reacting groups, between the Lewis acid and the Lewis base. So steric hindrance is significantly experienced when the nitrogen is surrounded with the back groups, that means the large groups, with the back groups. A clear example of this, it is tertiary amine, which is formed after replacement of all three hydrogen atoms of amine by alkyl groups. Although there is a strong possibility of effect in tertiary amine, unexpectedly, tertiary amine is least basic or the weakest base among the three classes of amine. Here we have primary, secondary, and tertiary amine. Because there is a large steric hindrance for Lewis acid, such as a hydrogen ion, to bond the nitrogen atom of amine, because the atom which is a nitrogen atom is overcrowded with the alkali groups. So among the amines, if we are given a different amines and then we are required to arrange them in order of increasing the basic strength, in order of increasing the basic strength, the tertiary amine will be less basic as compared with the other. Now this marks the end of our discussion regarding the factors affecting the organic reactions. In the next discussion, we'll start discussing about the hydrocarbons. That's a discussion kuhusu hydrocarbons. Kwa hiyo, we shall discuss kuhusu different factors. Now indeed, we'll mark the end of our introduction of organic chemistry. To may discuss kuanzia introduction yenyewe, tumeangalia the unique properties of carbon, tumeangalia categories of organic reactions, tumeangalia principles of showing organic reactions, tumeangalia types of organic reactions, na the mechanisms, na tumekuja kuangalia factors affecting the mechanisms of organic reactions. Kwa hiyo, stay tuned. Topic inayofuata tutaanza kudiscuss kuhusu hydrocarbons, na ndipo ambapo tutaanza organic one. Hii ilikuwa tu ni introduction. So thank you everybody, let me wish you nice studies.